We're going to go through and do a manual bleed of an Agrowplow AP71, which is the same as a 71, 51, 81 and a 91. What we're achieving is essentially the easiest way to bleed the tractor, to get any air that's in the oil back to the tractor and give clean, fresh oil in our system to allow a correct breakout operation. What we're going to do is lift up the wheels to allow our shanks, when they break out, to have maximum travel. Right, now, as you can see, our wheels are in the upright position. Our operator is going to take his remotes, put them into neutral position, and allow the oil to go back to the tractor. Once he's doing that, he has to creep forward really slowly, and our shanks will form out into a maximum breakout position. Now, this is a very quick operation to do. The farmer can quite easily do it within probably 5 minutes maximum time. The best way to do it is to see physically by how much oil or air is in the system. We walk up to the front of the machine, push our foot against the bottom of the shank, and push it back. If we can move our shank back, then it's insinuating that there is air in the hydraulic system. So as we can see now, all the oil is going back to the tractor and the shanks are in the maximum breakout position. You'll see once you're at complete operation, the plough flame will be flat. Our next step is to charge the shank's hydraulic system, which will essentially pull the machine backwards. Very important to make sure that we don't generate as minimal pressure as possible. By doing this, we have our park brake released in our tractor, which will allow the plough to pull the tractor back. When you are doing this safely, we do want to have people standing away. If you are going to crack the hydraulic system and do a forced bleed, make sure you're wearing your correct eye protection and gloves, PPE. As we can see now, the tractor's moving back, the shanks are pushing forward. Now we're filling our hydraulic system up with clean, fresh oil. The drive of the tractor is in neutral with the park brake off. He's charging the remotes. Now what he's doing is watching his pressure gauge to make sure that the pressure isn't spiked up too much. Now ideally, we want to keep this operation below 1,000 psi. If our hydraulic system pressure is increased to 2,000 psi or above, we can cause a honeycombing effect within the oil. Now what the driver, the operator will do is return his shank hydraulics back to 0 psi. And we want to be able to press on our shanks to make sure we can't push them backwards, which I'll show you how to do it. So there's two ways we can do this, by checking to make sure there is no air in the system. We need to grab the back of the shanks and try and lift it up. If we can't lift that up, we know we've got no air. What we can also do is grab hold of here and push against this. And you want to push to see if you can move that shank back. As you can see at the moment, we can't push that back. Any oil that we are compressing is taking the absorption in the accumulator. If you have any dramas, please consult your dealer. This procedure is in your operator's manual. It's also available online at agrowplow.com.au.